everyone, and welcome to Biology Professor. Today we're going to be talking about the central dogma of molecular biology. Now, what is dogma? Basically, dogma means an absolute truth. And in the case of the central dogma of molecular biology, this is the dogma that describes the flow of genetic information in all of life. The central dogma says that genetic information travels from DNA to RNA to protein. Let's look at this in a little more detail. Basically, all of life, so animals, including humans, also plants, fungi, bacteria, all living things, we all have cells that have DNA as our genetic information. DNA is capable of replicating. Through a process called DNA replication. Using enzymes called DNA polymerases. So this is whenever cells are dividing and replicating. For example, when your hair is growing or your fingernails are growing or bacteria are dividing or plants are growing, this is whenever the cells are replicating. They also have to replicate their DNA. Now, the genetic information that is contained in DNA in order to make proteins eventually, first that genetic information has to be transferred into RNA through a process called transcription. Transcription is when you have RNA polymerases that use the DNA as a template to make RNA. There are three main types of RNA. They are mRNA. Here the M stands for messenger RNA. So this is the RNA that contains all of that genetic information from the DNA. There's also rRNA or ribosomal RNA. Ribosomal RNA complexes with proteins to make the cellular organelle, the ribosome. There's also tRNA, or transfer RNA. Transfer RNA carries amino acids and works with the rRNA and within the ribosome to enable the process of translation. Translation is when the mRNA is read as a template by the rRNA and the proteins in the ribosome, which also use the tRNA to make proteins out of amino acids. It is these proteins that then go on to fulfill various cellular functions. So, for example, it is the proteins that are the enzymes that fulfill various cellular functions, like replicating things or phosphorylating things. Proteins are also the signaling aspects of the cell. There are motor proteins that help things move around the cell. So it's the proteins where most of the cell function is. Now, when the central dogma of molecular biology was set down, it was thought that DNA went to RNA, went to protein, always, no exceptions. Turns out that there is one important exception. There are examples of RNA where genetic information is contained in RNA and it moves backwards to DNA. Can you think of what example that might be? It's actually in retroviruses. So there are retroviruses that have their genetic information stored in RNA, and they use a process called reverse transcription. Of course, reverse transcription would be the opposite of normal transcription, so it's when they use an enzyme called reverse transcriptase to take their genetic information in RNA and convert it to DNA. One such virus that does this is HIV. So that is an important exception to the central dogma of molecular biology. So that is it for our discussion of this topic today. I hope you learned a lot, and thanks for watching.